I'm sorry I can't be with you today, but I just wanted to thank all of you for making the Corpus Christi Symphony possible. Without you, we don't have a Corpus Christi Symphony, and we really do appreciate everything you do. This last season, I think, has been an extraordinary season. The orchestra's made great strides. We have a better audience, more enthusiastic audience. These last 10 years have been a wonderful experience for me, being here in Corpus Christi with the orchestra and such wonderful friends as you. I think of back over the last 10 years and there have been some memorable moments. The opening with Van Cliburn, Andre Watts, Itzhak Perlman, Josh Bell. We've had some phenomenal artists, and there have been musical experiences with the orchestra such as a Beethoven Ninth, the Verdi Requiem, and some of the wonderful symphonies we played. It has been an extraordinary run and looking forward to another 50. And the orchestra and I are very, very enthusiastic about next season. Thank you very much again for all of your help.
Our 2012-2013 season featured 6 stunning classical concerts, an assortment of POP's special events, and the continuation of our mission to bring quality music education and entertainment to everyone in the Coastal Bend region. Here are some of the highlights from a season full of symphonic adventure with ever-changing, exquisite horizons. The season's opening concert, A Night in Old Vienna, sparkled with waltzes, polkas, and opera classics. The symphony, directed by Maestro John Giordano, presented crowd-pleasing Viennese favorites by the waltz king Johann Strauss Jr. and by Richard Strauss. Featured soloist and Grammy-nominated soprano Ava Pine delighted the audience with her virtuosity and charm. This magical evening, capped by a champagne reception, was made possible by the generosity of Wells Fargo and Louise Chapman. Barry and Rachmaninoff, the theme of our second subscription concert, left the audience dazzled by the virtuosity and Irish charm of Barry Douglas, a Tchaikovsky International Piano Competition gold medalist. Douglas performed Rachmaninoff's brilliant third piano concerto, earning an enthusiastic standing ovation from the crowd. Dvorak's Eighth Symphony and the overture to Rossini's opera La Cenerentola ended the concert on a high note. A special thank you to our sponsors Maureen Miller and Jean and Ellen Seaman. Home for the Holidays continued a beloved Yuletide tradition featuring Corpus Christi's best. Holiday highlights included traditional and classical favorites. Sopranos Shinyi Lin and Vanessa Becerra joined the CCSO along with more than 150 voices from the Corpus Christi Chorale and Del Mar Master Chorus. A special appearance by Santa and an audience sing-along put everyone in a merry mood for the season. Our sponsor for this special evening was the Pritchard Family Foundation. Our February concert, Romantic Masters, explored the sweeping lyricism of the Romantic Masters with a collection of musical masterpieces. Concertmaster William Kurt Thompson brought to life the passion of fantasy on Bizet's Carmen. Thompson's performance, along with the Moldau and Brahms' First Symphony, set a romantic evening for special Valentines. Our March concert, America the Beautiful, celebrated the vibrancy of America and her music. Maestro Giordano welcomed Mayor Nelda Martinez to the stage as special guest narrator for a memorable performance of Copland's A Lincoln Portrait. The evening continued with Grand Canyon Suite contributing an infectious passion for the beauty of the untouched American West. Ives' Variations on America and Schumann's New England Triptych rounded out this patriotic program. Our 67th season finale, Bolero and Beethoven, brought together works by Beethoven, Debussy, and Ravel in a perfect balance of grandeur and delicacy. Van Cliburn silver medalist Joyce Yang's brilliance and grace were showcased in her performance of Beethoven's majestic Emperor Piano Concerto. The program further unfolded with the delicate strains of Debussy's Nocturnes, followed by Ravel's timeless Bolero in a suspense-building grand finale. This concert concluded our subscription series and was made possible through the generosity of the estate of Helen Santos and Greg and Marcia Robertson. On January 8th, the Corpus Christi Symphony Orchestra partnered with the Classical Mystery Tour to present a rollicking musical blast from the past and an unforgettable evening filled with more than 20 Beatles favorites. More than a rock concert, it was an evening for those who loved and lived the 70s. A special thanks to Charles and Gail Dorain for helping us rock on. The CCSO marked the end of its 67th season with its gift to the community, Pops in the Park at Whataburger Field. Back this year by popular demand, our second Community Pops concert featured a fresh program of musical favorites from the silver screen and a salute to the armed forces. More than 5,000 attendees enjoyed music from their favorite movies, classic ballpark concessions, and a magnificent fireworks show. Sponsored by Wells Fargo with support from the City of Corpus Christi and Coastal Bend Community Foundation, Pops in the Park continues to be a South Texas favorite. The Corpus Christi Symphony Orchestra presented two free performances designed especially for 4th and 5th grade students at the Performing Arts Center on the Texas A&M University Corpus Christi campus. The Patricia Furley Education Concerts were attended by about 2,200 children from the Corpus Christi, Flower Bluff, Gregory Portland, Port Aransas, West Oso, Robstown, and Toloso Midway Independent School Districts, as well as home and private school students. Thanks to the efforts of school administrators, classrooms of eager students were transported by bus to the Performing Arts Center for these musical discovery concerts, which were generously underwritten by HEB, Navy Army Federal Credit Union, and Target. Additional support was given by Texas A&M University Corpus Christi and the Texas A&M University Corpus Christi Arts Advisory Council. The Corpus Christi Area Youth Orchestra has been supported by the Corpus Christi Symphony Orchestra since 1996 and is proud to call Texas A&M University Corpus Christi its home. The Youth Orchestra is directed by Dr. Jose Flores and Dr. Melissa Melendez is assistant director. The CCAYO's success has resulted in such large numbers of young musicians that this season exceeded 100 student performers. As you have seen, the 2012-2013 Corpus Christi Symphony Orchestra season has been stellar. We have experienced growth in our audience numbers, youth outreach, community standing, and name recognition, as well as growth in diversifying our audiences, our musical offerings, and growth towards our financial goals. As we conclude this wonderful season and look forward to the next, we offer sincere thanks to our sponsors, both new sponsors and loyal, long-standing sponsors, who make our programming possible. To our society members and supporters, who sustain our commitment to the community. To our intrepid board of directors, whose direction and dedication maintain our integrity. To Maestro John Giordano and our excellent musicians, who provide musical experiences not often enjoyed in even major cities. And to our wonderful staff, Robert, Vicky, Rosara, and Abby, whose hard work makes it all possible.
Thank you!
Wells Fargo.
Thank you!
HEB. Thank you!
Rock on M Ranch.
Thank you!
City of Corpus Christi.
Thank you!
Greg and Marcia Robertson.
Thank you!
Pritchard Family Foundation.
Thank you.
Valero.
Thank you.
Dorain Wealth Management.
Thank you. Maureen Miller.
Thank you.
Symphony Guild.
Thank you.
Louise Chapman.
Thanks. Jean and Ellen Seaman.
Thank you.
Navy Army Community Credit Union.
Thank you.
AEP.
the Corpus Christi Symphony Orchestra's glittering 67th season. Your city, your music, your orchestra.